And finally, it is Friday, and today I have for you a little bit of this, a little bit of that, a little something else, all to celebrate the weekend.
Hooray!
It is the first Friday of Lent, or as it's known by its holiday name, Fish Fry Friday. Most of us are very familiar here in Western New York with the idea of taking the church tradition of not eating meat on Fridays during Lent and turning it into the truly religious experience of enjoying fish that has been battered, deep fried, and accompanied by French fries, coleslaw, and the collective elated delusion that the calories do not in any way count. The fish fry is much beloved, and it is certainly most buffalo, so much so that we enjoy annually curating the Channel 2 Fish Fry Map to detail the best spots to devour this gem of the sea by way of the deep fryer. But this actual official holiday got its start thanks to a Wisconsin native and freelance writer named Caleb Westfall. Now, Caleb claims to have not missed a Friday night fish fry since sometime in 2013. Even if he is from Wisconsin, he definitely seems most buffalo. Our deep fried treat correspondent, Nate Benson, is looking into the challenges of keeping the fishes frying and the faithful fed in the midst of a pandemic. That is coming up later on Channel 2. Oh, and by the way, I thought you might like to know today is also National Tartar Sauce Day, which seems to make perfect sense. And one other reminder that you can find our fish fry map at WGRZ.com. It is a great one-stop shop to find Western New York's favorites, and we count on you to help us fill it out. There's a form right on the website for you to share your favorite spot if you are willing to let the secret out. And a few of you weighed in on Facebook letting us know your favorite fish fries in Western New York, and you didn't waste any time either. I got about 75 responses just within the first 15 minutes. And of course, we always welcome your fish fry portraits as well. You can share your photos using the hashtag #BeOnTwo. And our Fish Fry Friday is coming with a side of gratitude as we bring you an update on a story we brought you a couple weeks ago here on Most Buffalo. You may remember Megan Haven. We featured her City of Good COVID Neighbors Facebook group. She collects money to buy and deliver meals to those in need, supporting both local restaurants and other community groups. And we got a lovely thank you note from Megan saying, "Dear Kate and Most Buffalo team, thank you for having me on Most Buffalo to talk about City of Good COVID Neighbors. We've already raised an additional $1,500 since it aired." And she went on to say, "You said that one person can make a difference, but what really makes a difference are a bunch of good neighbors. We really appreciate all you do." And thank you, Megan, for your kind words and for your great update. And thank you all for watching. We hope you have a great weekend. We'll see you back here Monday on Most Buffalo. Until then, I'm Kate Welshofer. Be well, stay well, and I'll see you next.